I believe that there's a double battle up here, and if Queen's PP wasn't so low on absorb, I probably would be okay just slapping a potion on Clam. But that is not the case. And it's not that far to the Pokemon Center, so we shall go to the Pokemon Center. It's not that hard. So let's get some healing on. All right. And let's get to Rustboro. Wrong way. Wrong way. So, I think I'm going to run from this wild encounter and any wild encounters I get here. Mainly because I don't need the levels at this point, and I've got a couple more trainer battles before I get to the city. Yep, I was thinking she was there, and then there's a double battle on the bridge, if I remember correctly. So, we'll take care of this, then go deal with that. Water is amazing. Ooh, a Lotad. Okay, this is interesting. This is actually quite interesting. I don't remember what level we learned absorb at, and I don't know if the players in this game follow the rules that you do. So I don't know if this thing has absorb. But if it has absorb and I throw Mudkip out, throw Clam out, that's it's gonna be no bueno. So let's stick with Queen for now. Okay. I think Queen will be fine. Yeah, Queen will be fine. Might have to hit it with three absorbs since that first one was a crit. Yeah. But we should be okay. Especially since it's just growling us. And if Game Freak, the Pokemon company, Nintendo, whoever actually dictates the difficulty of these games, wanted these to be more difficult games, all they really have to do is up the AI of these trainers. Okay, so that's going to be a problem. Shroomish is a pure grass type, so let's throw Clam in. And okay, levels lower, levels, levels lower. And it may not have a grass type move, so yeah, I say that right as it uses a grass type move, of course. Does decent damage, but not enough for me to be concerned. Not enough for concern. So we'll go ahead and knock this Shroomish out. Easy as pie. Key lime pie to be precise. I haven't had pie in a really long time. I might have to pick up a key lime pie the next time I'm at the grocery store. I could probably make one, but that's a lot of work and I don't want to. So I'm probably just going to pick one up. Let me add that to my grocery list. Because if I don't do it now, I will forget. That is something that is key about me is if I don't do something as I am thinking about it, I will certainly forget it. So, key lime pie. And that will be with the frozen goods. Frozen. Wonderful. All right, so had to put the key lime pie on my shopping list. Okay, this is interesting. I think Seedot is in the forest in this game. I could have picked one of those up. Though I don't like C-Dot, or its fully evolved form Shiftry nearly as much as I do Lotad and Lombre, or Lotad and Ludicolo. So, yeah. So I'm going to use Lotad and focus, or I'm going to focus on Lotad with Queen. I'm going to focus on Lotad with both of my Pokemon. Okay. And then we'll knock out Sadot. C-Dot. Oof. I'm not worried about Bide. And they're only level 6, so. So I am minimally concerned about the threat these Pokemon actually pose to this team. The good thing about having few Pokemon as opposed to a large team is that it's easier to distribute levels. You're not having to spend hours grinding this massive team up, or even a specific Pokemon. So trying to build a balanced team as you go, even though it may not be perfectly balanced for all situations, is somewhat important to me. And something else, I do not like using the experience share, so I don't. I believe in Sun and Moon and Galar it was required. I know for a fact it was in Galar, but I think it was in Sun and Moon as well, which really irks me. I mean, I guess it's useful if you want it, but I never want it, so I would rather it not be a thing, so please don't make it be a thing. I didn't mind, and this actually might be a gen where it is, but I didn't mind experience share when you could put it on a specific Pokemon to train them up, like a hatched egg or whatever. That is a very, very useful implementation of something like the experience share. And I suppose the rework where it, excuse me, distributes experience to all of your Pokemon is appropriate, or not appropriate, but like it makes sense. Like if you say that, like if you tell me that you're going to give experience to all the Pokemon, I'm like, okay, yeah, sure, that makes sense, but it's not something that I want. And I'm not sure that it was a welcome addition to the games, is how I'll phrase that. So can I go? I believe this is the gym. Is this the gym? No, that is the school. The gym is, yeah, the gym's up here. Can I just go in and let's challenge the gym? I don't think I need to battle the gym trainer, so I'm going to try to avoid them. All right, so here we are. Roxanne, our first gym leader. We've got a water grass type and a water type. Queen has absorb, a grass type move, a stab grass type move. Clam has mud slap, a ground type move. I don't he's he she he doesn't have ground typing yet, but and he also has water gun, a stab water type move. I don't think we're going to have any trouble. So let us jump in here. Ooh, it took me a little bit longer to get here than I thought it would. So let us knock Roxanne out, and I think we might go ahead and end the stream here. We'll see. We'll see. So let's absorb. I'm going to try to use Queen for as much as possible to preserve my precious. Oof. Oof. That was a hard hit. My. My precious clam. All right. I don't think we're in any real danger here. Yeah, we're not in any real danger here, but it's just. It's annoying. It's annoying. All right, so. There we go. Geodude is down. Does she just have the Geodude and the Nosepass in this game? Or does she have another Geodude? I think it's just the Geo. Oh no, she's got two Geodudes. Let's keep Queen out. Okay, two Geodudes and the Nosepass. Oof. These moves are doing a lot of damage, but Absorb is recovering quite a bit as well. And doing a lot of damage. Like, it's four times super effective at stab, so. So, like, while they're able to do a lot of damage to me, like, I'm going to be at full health after this. So I am minimally concerned. Yeah. You know, Queen might actually be able to take the nose pass down for us. I mean, I'm not going to switch her out here. But she could do it. It is theoretically possible. And she just gained a level, so... that makes it even more likely. So, here's for the nose pass. I am not switching. Grab a drink of fresh, clean, crisp, clear water. And let us take out this... Okay, I wasn't going to. I legitimately did not remember that move. Oof, Queen is not doing as much damage to this. Oh, Nose Pass is a lot higher level. I'm still not concerned. I'm pretty sure we can still beat this. I just wasn't expecting that level gap. So this isn't a true blind playthrough of this game by any stretch of the imagination, it almost feels like it because it's been so long since I've really been immersed in the Pokemon ecosystem and immersed in a Pokemon game, and especially these older games, the Gen 3 games. It's been so long since I've played them that so much of it just seems like a surprise. Like, I vaguely know what's happening, but nothing's happening exactly like I expect. And that is really fun. Okay. Well, I would consider hopping over to Clam, but I can't switch out thanks to that block that was thrown on me first turn. And Queen's not exactly in danger of losing, so I want to give her the chance to, you know, make her mark on the team fairly early on. And as a note, oof, that did it. As a note, I'm not particularly attached to my starters typically. I know that somewhat frequently I do switch them out. So a water gun or two. Okay, I don't have any other Pokemon, so. A water gun or two should take this nose pass down pretty easy. Unless she uses like a full restore, and she doesn't. Yep. First gym badge in the books. That is absolutely beautiful. Stunning, marvelous. Okay. All right. Yes, you lost. Give me my gym badge. Now. All right. I wonder how much money we have. I want to go stock up on some Pokeballs. Oh, okay. I wonder where you get the HM cut. Yeah, like I said, TMs can only be used once. I wonder where cut is at in this game. Let's go heal up, stock up on Pokeballs. Alright. I was wondering how that event triggered. So he took the goods. So let's go heal. And then grab some Pokeballs. Though, like I said, I don't think there's anything over here that I'm particularly interested in. I'm also going to look up where you get Pokemon or cut in Pokemon Emerald. I'm not sure if it's a required HM. Okay, so go to Rustboro City. I'm there. House next to the Pokemon Center. Okay. So I am not too far away. Let us go grab this really quick. And then maybe deal with this Devin dude. Is it this guy? You're obviously a skilled trader. No, wait, don't say a word. I can tell just by looking at you. I'm sure that you can put this hidden machine to good use. No need to be modest or shy. Go on, take it. Obtained the HM01 exclamation point. Snell put away the HM01 in the TMs in HM's pocket. That hidden machine, or HM for short, is Cut. An HM move is one that can be used by a Pokemon outside of battle. Any Pokemon that's learned Cut can chop down thin trees if the trainer has earned the Stone Badge. And unlike an HM or a TM, an HM can be used more than once. I know that it's simply a game mechanic, the HM versus TM distinction. But I wonder how that would actually play out in the real world, especially the restriction on it, having to have a specific badge. Like, would your Charizard just not fly if you didn't have the right TM? I find that somewhat hard to believe. Do you get the Premier Ball for every 10? Yes, you do. So let's go ahead and do that. I don't think I want to start buying healing items just quite yet. As much as I lambasted him earlier in this stream, it would be somewhat ironic if I stocked up on them. Though, like I said, I do think that they are somewhat useful. They're just situational this early. And certainly not something that I would use in a battle. Not until you get full restores would I seriously consider using them regularly in battle. Oh, it's you. You're that fantastic trainer who helped me in the Petalburg Woods. In fact, I am. Help me. I was robbed by Team Aqua. I have to get the Devon goods back. If I don't, I'm going to be in serious trouble. All right. Let's go get these goods back. A Whismur. I like the Whismur line in concept, but I do not like it in execution. So, come on. So, it's a Pokemon that I want to like, and I would like to be able to use confidently in battle, but I don't, and I can't. So, in fact, I don't even know what it learns by level up. It's actually what I'm thinking about. Isn't it like mostly like bad sound type or bad sound based moves and mediocre normal type moves? Might have to look that up. It might in fact be a useful Pokemon to have. But for some reason, I remember it being terrible. Or it might be a stats thing. I do not in fact remember, so. Oh, we're going to tackle. And we're going to tackle. Ooh, poisoned. Ooh, poison actually might be a problem in this generation. So, and another tackle, and it should be down. Both of my Pokemon gained a few. I'm going to keep Clam out. Oh, yeah. I pulled up Wismer's learn set. It's learn up moves. It's level up. Learn by level up moves. There's nothing in here that stands out as particularly impressive. Hyper voice at level 45. That's not what I want. It has an okay selection of TM moves, Solar Beam, and Fire Blast being the most notable. Flamethrower as well. Shockwave, which is okay. Shadow Ball and Blizzard. Actually, Blizzard and Ice Beam are both really good. Shadow Ball's okay as well. I wonder if Exploud gets... I wonder if Exploud gets more. I'm thinking about what I want to do for a team, and I've never actually used one of these in a playthrough. And so it might be beneficial for me to pick one up. I'm going to go ahead and tackle this Nincada. So, while I do this happy little bit of research. That's not the generation I'm looking at. Okay, so in this generation, it only has 480 base stat total. I mean, it's not terrible. It's not the best by any means, but I don't think it needs to be. We're not building a competitive team here. And it's not like a Nuzlocke or anything. I'm getting to pick my Pokemon team. And this is Exploud, by the way. So... Okay, so it learns Crunch once it evolves, which is a pretty decent move. Really, really high level. At 72, it learns Boom Burst, which is 140 base power, 100 accurate move that gets that normal typing. It actually has a really decent selection of... Actually has an amazing... An amazing selection of... Hold on. I was not looking at Gen 3. Okay. So Gen 3 is less impressive. At level 40, it learns Hyper Beam. And then at level 63, it learns Hyper Voice, both of which are decent moves. Actually, really good moves. And its TM set's actually pretty good. I might pick one of these up really quick. The only potential downside I see... Alright, so yeah, we're going to go ahead and catch a Wismer. I think it might be a bit of a challenge until we get Wismer leveled up and trained well. But I think long term this could actually be a decent addition to the team. I say this right after I said Wismer was a terrible Pokemon, by the way. I mean, it's not a great Pokemon. Ooh, and I have no antidotes. I think Mudkip's going to faint before we can get back to the Pokemon Center, but such is life. I think Wismer will be a decent addition to the team. It's a Pokemon that I've... I don't know why I thought it was so bad. I mean, like I said, it's not a great Pokemon. It's not the best Pokemon that I'll have on my team, but I think it could be a solid addition for at least a little while. I'll go ahead and throw it on. I can get attached to the Pokemon that I play through with. So this could be a good addition. I know that they're in the cave. I was actually trying to avoid that trainer. I did a wonderful job at it. All right, so we've got a Shroomish. Level 9 Shroomish. And the good thing, something that will be super useful with a Whismur, is that these grass type Pokemon won't be such an issue. All right, so we're gonna hit this Shroomish with a couple of tackles. This may not be good. I don't think that I would say that we're going to lose this, but this is not going in our favor at the moment. I don't think long term we'll lose it. She only has one Pokemon. We might lose this. We might lose this battle. Especially since Clem has been paralyzed thrice in a row. This would be a hell of a battle to lose as my first loss. wouldn't it? All right. I don't think Astonish is going to do that much. We'll see, but I'm not expecting it to really do anything. Nah. All right, so we're just probably going to trade absorbs, and hopefully our absorbs are more absorby than oof. Oof. And his will be neutral. I think Astonish might be our best bet. Or I could hit it with a couple of growls. Is Astonish a physical attack? I don't know. I don't know. This is not something that should be. I'm going to try it. I don't want to spend a ton of time Googling that on live stream. So I am going. Growl lowers attack, not defense. And I'm paralyzed. You know, that is four times in a row my Pokemon's been paralyzed. That is ridiculous. You know, we might still win this. I'm just not optimistic about that. All right, so as long as we keep breaking through the paralysis, we should be okay. Though this would be this is just really stupid. Really, really stupid. All right, one more queen. One more. You got this. Wonderful. I do think that growl came in handy because those tackles could have been bad, but his attack was down one stage. Ooh, nature powder. All right, so I'm going to run back and heal. Actually, I think this might be a good place to end the stream for tonight. Been streaming a little bit over an hour and a half. I said somewhere around 90 minutes. And that was a much too close of a call. So yeah, that's where we'll end it this fine evening.